Madame Wong's to Starwood to the whiskey on the strip. You can hear the crashing, blasting strum of bands that come to be real hip and get a record contract from a talent scout someday. They'll sell their ass, their cocks and balls, they'll take the check and walk away. If they're lucky, they'll get famous for a week or two perhaps. They'll buy some ugly clothes to wear and hope the business don't collapse before some stupid magazine decides they're really good. They're a Tinseltown rebellion band from downtown Hollywood. Tinseltown rebellion. Tinseltown rebellion band. It's a little bitty Tinseltown rebellion. A Tinseltown rebellion band. They used to play all kinds of stuff, and some of it was nice. Some of it was musical, but then they took some guy's advice. To get a record deal, he said, they would have to be more punk. Forget their chops and play real dumb, or else they would be sunk. So off they go to SIR to learn some stupid riffs and practice all their poses in between their powder sniffs. Chop a line now, snort it up now. When they think they've got it, they launch a new career. Who gives a fuck if what they play is somewhat insincere? Tinseltown Rebellion. Tinseltown Rebellion Band. A Tinseltown Rebellion. A Tinseltown Rebellion Band. Did you know that in Tinseltown, the people down there think that substance is a bore? And if your new wave group looks good, they'll hurry on back for more of leather groups and plastic groups and groups that look real queer. The Tinseltown aficionados come to see and not to hear. But then again, this system works as perfect as a dream. It works for all those record company pricks who come to skim the cream from the cesspools of excitement where Jim Morrison once stood. It's the Tinseltown Rebellion from down